All right, Orson, that was a great take. Let's do another one. This is take three with Hollywood legend Orson Welles doing the spooky ooky voiceover for Michael Jackson's Thriller.
Under protest.
Whatever you say, Orson. Whatever you say, buddy. All right, and we are rolling.
Darkness falls across the land. The midnight hour is close at hand. Creatures crawl in search of blood to terrorize your neighbor. HUD? What? Cut. Do you really mean that?
Sorry, Orson, mean what?
Well, it's just bad copy. You have blood and hood trying to rhyme.
That's correct.
Well, it doesn't work, you see. You'd have to mangle one of the words to make it fit the rhyme scheme.
That's also correct. So, mangle them.
It's too much directing around here. No one would be living actor this way in Shakespeare the way you do this. It's impossible. There's no known way in the English language of rhyming blood and hood. Get me a jury and show me how you can rhyme blood and neighborhood, and I'll go down on you.
That's not necessary.
I'll do it.
Is that a promise?
Vincent Price. What in the hell are you doing here, you moneyed cookbook whore?
Now, Orson, we both know there are two men in this world equipped to read spooky monologues. Let's not throw stones in such lovely glass houses.
Yes, two men. Myself and Dean Martin.
Hilarious! Just hilarious! Did Don Rickles write that one for you?
I've been writing and directing my own material since radio. I don't need Rickles and neither did Sinatra.
I needed you like I needed another Hearst biopic.
Kane was never about Hearst!
Gentlemen, please, 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 I have no patience for your old-timey references, okay? Look, we are making the future here, okay? Michael Jackson's Thriller is the future of art.
Terrible.
Orson, I invited Vincent here to stand in, just in case you're dissatisfied with the copy. I know you have very high standards.
Good sir, I merely have standards.
And I wouldn't want you having to compromise those.
Well, you know, I kind of need the money. I'm trying to finish Don Quixote.
No. I wouldn't want you to sell out.
That's all I do now. I work with Bugs Bunny. I was in the Muppet movie for like 10 seconds.
Darkness falls across the land. The midnight hour is close at hand. Creatures crawl in search of blood. To terrorize your neighborhood. Whosoever shall be found without the soul for getting down must stand and face the hounds of hell and rot in the shell.
Yeah! Absolutely brilliant! Absolutely insipid! How can you stand and face the hounds of hell if you're rotting inside a corpse's shell? And a corpse is a shell. It's meaningless. It still didn't rhyme at all.
It doesn't need to. Oh, thou blubbery fool, can't you see? You're straightening portraits in a bordello. Do you think when I started the Tingler, I cared about art? You're dying, breed, Orson. Get out of the way.
Well, he speaks for you, does he?
Eloquently enough to please the client, so yes.
If I must go, then it shall be. To the last, I grapple with thee.
Boring.
For King's sake, I spit my last breath at thee. From hell's heart, I stab at thee!
Oh.
Hello, I'm Orson Welles. I apologize for a little play gave you a fright, but we thought for the Halloween season we should get a bit spooky. That's the magic of theater, really. Taking you from a different time, a different place, to things you never could imagine. The real thriller is live theater. Oh, like Polonius behind his curtain, I am slain! Today!
That's enough, Orson.
Perchance!
Well done, Vincent. We've got a little bit left. Why don't we keep going?
Certainly.
The only thing I need now is the laugh.
Absolutely.
Let's roll. Let's try it again.